So let's start. Here we are solving the single source shortest path algo, that is the Dijkstra's algorithm. As the name suggests, we are going to choose the source and going to calculate the shortest path possible to all the other nodes. So let's assume node 1 to be the source. Here we are assuming this to be the source and explore all its neighbor. We can solve Dijkstra's algorithm in both directed and undirected graph, but here we are taking the undirected graph and we are assuming all the weights to be infinity. And the source node 0. The weight of the source node is 0 and all the other nodes are infinity. The weight represents the distance from the source node and the edge weight is given. So now let's mark the source to be visited for now and write the unvisited nodes here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All these nodes are unvisited and the weights associated with them are 0. The weight for the node 1 is 0, for node 2 it's infinity, for node 3 is infinity, and for all the other nodes is infinity, as we can see. Now we have marked it visited, so we are shading it just for the sake of clarity. Now we are going to the second node. So the distance is 3. 0 plus 3 is 3. Since it's less than infinity, so we are going to update the distance, the weight of the node. It's 3. And for here, it's 0 plus 6 is less than infinity, it's 6. Now we are going to update it. So the new weights are 0, 3, 6, infinity, infinity, infinity. And now we are going to take the node which is having the minimum weight out of the unvisited nodes. So the weight for the second node is 3 and the third node is 6 and for rest it's infinity. So the minimum weight is 3 associated with the second node. So we are going to take the node 2 into consideration and mark it visited. We are marking it visited. And the unvisited nodes that remains are, it's 5. So now exploring all the neighbors of the second node. Remember, we are going to explore only the neighbors which are unvisited, not the unvisited ones. So the ones which are unvisited and directly connected to the node 2 are node 3. It's 3 plus 2 is less than 6. So we are going to update it. 3 plus 5, 8 less than infinity. So we are going to update it. So we are not going to update the weight of this because it's already visited. So now the new weights are 0, 3, 5, and 8, infinity, infinity. The remaining unvisited nodes are 4, 5, 6, because we are going to mark it visited, since from the remaining nodes it's having the minimum weight. 1, 2, 3. And we're going to explore its neighbors. So its neighbor is 5. 5 plus 2 is 7, less than infinity. 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. So it's 8. We are not going to update it. It's already 8. And from the rest of the nodes, 5 is having the minimum weight. So we are going to mark it visited now. 1, 2, 3, 5. Weight remaining are 4 and 6. The weights associated with them are 0, 3, 5, 8, 7, and infinity. So we are going to explore its neighbors. 7 plus 6, it's 13. It's more than 8, so we are not going to update it. 7 plus 5, it's 12. It's less than infinity, so we are going to update it. And from the remaining nodes, it's clear that we are going to take node 4 into consideration since its weight is minimum out of the unvisited nodes. And we are going to mark it visited. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All these nodes are visited and only 6 remains. The weight associated with them are 6, 3, 5, 8, 7 and 12. Now only 6 remains and all the other nodes are unvisited. So we are going to mark it visited and we are not going to change the weight. So now, as we can clearly see, from node 1, we have calculated the minimum path possible to all the other nodes. Thank you for the same.